skies is the sign of good coffee the world over. Wherever coffee is enjoyed, it means world-famous Maxwell House coffee. Look for the sign of good coffee, and tomorrow enjoy a cup of heartwarming Maxwell House. Always good to the last drop.
Maxwell House Coffee presents Mama, the award-winning television drama, starring Peggy Wood.
I remember the June mornings when I was a girl on Steiner Street. I remember the mornings in our house. How quiet our kitchen was just before 7 in the morning. With no sound but the ticking of the clock. But when Papa's alarm went off, all of us scrambling to see who would be first in the bathroom. All of us but Mama, who had already been up a whole hour preparing breakfast. And by 7:30, the quiet in the kitchen was shattered by the buzz and the chatter and the love of a happy family. My family. I remember my brother Nels boasting to me of his baseball prowess. And my little sister Dagmar reviewing her spelling lesson with Papa. But most of all, when I think back on those bright June mornings, most of all, I remember Mama.
Yes, here's Mama, brought to you by world-famous Maxwell House Coffee. Famous for flavor for over a half century, today more than ever, the sign of good coffee means your money's worth and more. Today more than ever, it's your guarantee that Maxwell House is true economy. Because you're sure of so many more cups of truly good coffee in every pound. Coffee that's always good to the last drop.
Ask me another word, Papa.
House.
House. H-O-U-S-E. House.
Good.
Another one, Papa.
Man.
Oh, that's too easy, Papa.
Well, dog.
Tiger.
Mississippi.
Mississippi. Capital M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I, Mississippi.
Well, that's good, Dagmar.
But that's not really a hard word, Papa.
I bet you couldn't spell it when you were my age.
I can't spell it now.
I'm the best speller in our whole class.
You don't need to boast so.
But I think it's just fine that Dagmar is such a good speller. Only last term it was the thing she was worst at.
Because I didn't like the teacher, Mama. But Miss Reamer lets us have lots of spelling bees, and I like those better than anything.
I used to like spelling bees, too. I'd always miss out on the first word, and then I wouldn't have anything to do till the bright kids got through working.
Mess you for not as bad as that.
Oh, well, I can spell man and dog. Man, M-U-N, dog, D-I-G.
Nels, you spelled mun and dig.
Did I?
Oh, Nels is so funny.
For heaven's sake, spelling doesn't take intelligence, Dagmar. All it takes is memory. Even a moron could be a good speller.
That's right, Dagmar. Katrin gets 100 in spelling all the time.
Marty.
Did you ever win the championship of the entire lower grades, Katrin?
My gosh, how can I remember that far back?
Well, Miss Reamer says that she thinks that I have a very good chance to win a championship next Friday night.
Then, do not get so excited you forget to eat your breakfast.
Don't forget now, Papa. It's the championship spelling bee next Friday night, and you're coming.
Oh, we are all coming.
You think I'll win?
I don't know.
Your teacher says you might. I think you have a very good chance you will.
Yeah, but whatever you do, do not worry.
Oh, I've got to win, Mama. Because if I don't, then Tommy Jordan will. And I hate him.
Oh. Dagmar, it's not nice to hate people.
I don't care. I hate Tommy.
Oh, but you play with him all the time.
Yes, and whenever I do, he always pulls my hair or something like that. He's mean and I hate him.
Well, his sister says Tommy's a pretty good speller.
I don't care. He's not as good as I am.
We'll find out Friday night.
Ask me another word, Papa.
It's time for Papa to go to work.
Well, you ask me, Nell.
Esophagus.
E-S-O-F-P-H,
champion.
Well, esophagus isn't a fourth grade word.
Well, you still ought to be able to spell it. You've got one. Where your oatmeal goes every morning.
I don't care. It isn't a fourth grade word.
Well, goodbye.
Wait a minute, Papa. I'll come with you.
I have to give you some money.
Money?
To make the insurance payment. It is the first of the month.
Yeah, I will pay it during the noon hour.
Bye, Mama.
Goodbye, Nell. Now, come, Dagmar. It is time for you to go to school, too.
Well, me too, I guess.
Yeah.
Well, you think I'll win the spelling championship, Mama?
Can't you talk about anything else?
Hmm? I'll talk about it if I want. want to. Do you think I'll win, Mama?
I hope so. Now go on, Dagmar.
Bye. You coming, Katrin?
No, you go on, Dagmar. I want to talk to Katrin for a minute.
What about?
Go on, nosy.
I'm not even nosy. Tommy!
What is it, Mama?
Katrin, why do you pick on your little sister so much lately?
I don't, Mama.
Spell esophagus. A little girl like that.
Well, that's just because she was bragging so much.
You not want her to be a good speller?
But you always scolded me when I bragged, and you never do her.
After all the trouble that Dagmar had with spelling, I think she can afford to grow now.
But you never say anything to her about anything, Mama, and she never has to help around the house with the beds or the dishes or anything.
She does just as much as you did when you were her age.
She doesn't either, Mama.
I have always tried to do my best to be fair with all your children. And maybe I have not been so. But this I know. I do not love one of you any more than I love the others.
Sorry, Mama. I didn't mean to do anything bad.
I think you are still not too big to sit on my lap.
Oh, Mama, I didn't mean to be sad to Dagmar. I love her. She's the best sister in the whole world.
I have two very fine little girls.
I forgot my speller.
Oh. I'll get it for you, honey.
What's the matter with Katrin?
Nothing.
Goodbye, Mama.
Goodbye.
Come on, Dagmar. On the way to school, I'll give you words to practice on.
Golly, thanks.
Cat.
That's too easy.
Then my older girl says, spell Mississippi. And just like that, Dagmar spells it perfect. She's fine spelling, that girl.
Well. Still bragging about the way your kid can spell, huh, Hansen?
Oh, I do not mean to brag, Mr. Jordan, but she is darn fine speller.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And her teachers say maybe she has good chance to win the spelling championship of the whole lower grades.
Oh, fat chance.
Well, I only know what the teachers say.
You don't know what she's talking about. My kid, Tommy, is going to win that spelling bee just like that.
Oh, I remember now. Dagmar said your Tommy was fine speller.
Fine speller? Mm-hmm. Why, he can spell Mississippi frontwards, backwards, and upside down.
Did they make them do that?
That is a joke, sweet. Joke,
yeah? Oh!
Yeah, they give him plenty of them tough $5 words, though. Yeah. Real tongue twisters and jawbreakers. Mm. I wouldn't figure on your kid lasting very long.
Well, I think she will do as good as any.
Oh, you do you?
Yeah, and if you will excuse me, Mr. Jordan, I think maybe she will do a little bit better than some.
Oh? You wouldn't care to make a little bet on that, would you, sweet?
Well, I'm not much of a one for betting.
Oh. Don't think your kid has a chance, huh?
I did not say that.
Yeah, what's your bet then?
Well, for one thing, I do not have the money.
Yeah. What is the other thing?
I do not want to.
Oh, afraid, huh?
No, I am not afraid.
Yeah, prove it.
Well, why should I have to bet if I
now,
do not want
to? If you think your kid is such a great speller, get some money and bet.
I do not want to.
Mm. I wouldn't either if I was you. Because my kid, Tommy, is going to beat her brains off.
That is not what the teacher says.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, that is what this says. Put up or shut up.
All right, then, I will bet.
Hey, look who says he didn't have no money.
This is the money for the insurance.
Oh, trying to back out now.
I am not. I will bet all of this.
Oh. Eddie, you hold the money.
It's a pleasure.
That was all
for Eddie. Well, it was a terrible thing. They were put right out in the streets without even their furniture, including the heirloom she got from her mother.
Yeah, that is all for Eddie.
But heaven knows what's going to become of them.
Ellie, hold back here, Mama.
Oh.
It's
a
word with me.
Well, he set me.
Well, she pulled my necktie yesterday.
No. I want you children to play together nicely.
Can we have a cookie?
Well, it is almost supper time.
We eat supper very late at our house.
Oh, well, maybe I'll have one for Tommy.
Well, if Tommy has one, I can too, can I?
Yeah, Tommy. Yeah.
Just one, and no more. Thank I do not you. Want any spoiled appetites.
Hey, my family's been trying for years to find something to do that.
What?
Spoil my appetite.
That's what upstairs is picking them out. Hey, wait for me!
Play nice together. Like elephants, they are at that age. Well, even his wife's sister wouldn't take them in.
Oh, that is awful, Yanni. Take who in?
Well, the ones I was telling you about, the friends of Mrs. Jansrud's friends.
Oh,
Well, I must be getting home.
Yeah, that is awful. Oh,
hello.
Oh, hello, Henry.
Hello, Martha. Yeah. But you two girls here, somebody's ears are burning, I'll bet.
Huh? Well, don't even speak that word, Betty.
What do you mean, Jenny?
Oh, Jenny, was you telling me about some friends of Mrs. Jansrud's?
Yeah, every week he bets his whole wages on the horse races. Mm-hmm. And now they are destitute.
Oh.
I think that people who gamble ought to go to jail. Don't you, Hansen?
Well, Jenny, I...
What does Lars know about gambling?
Well, he's a man. And they always know what they should not.
I tell you that nobody from this household could be put out on the street because Lars gambles away his whole wages. I can promise you that.
Well, I got to be going. Goodbye, Martha.
Goodbye, Andy.
Hello? Oh, yeah, Mr. Jordan. Yeah. Yeah, I will tell him. Yeah, goodbye. Tommy? Your papa says it is time for you to come home now. He says he wants you to study your spelling. There. Did you have a good day, Lars?
Yeah, pretty good.
Did you pay the insurance at the wound?
No, Martha, I did not.
Oh, well, if you forgot, tomorrow will be all right. Only do not put it off. We are late already.
Yeah, I know, Martha, I know.
Well, good night, Miss Hansen.
Good night, Tommy.
Good night. Hansen, I didn't see you there. Good night.
Good night, Tommy.
Hello, Papa.
Why are you not studying the spelling like Tommy does?
Would you help me with a word?
No, Dagmar. Papa is just home from work. He is tired.
No, I'm not too tired for that, Martha. All right, Dagmar.
I'll get my spelling.
Good.
Don't forget now, Papa. Nothing to eat.
Yeah, now let's see. Where will I find the one I am thinking of?
What is it?
It's where the oatmeal goes in the morning.
Oh, esophagus.
Yeah.
E-S-O-P-H-A-G-U-S, esophagus. I learned it.
Oh, that is good, Dagmar. Mississippi.
That's a long one, Pa.
Well, you better learn it. That kid next door can spell it backwards, sideways, and upside down.
M-I-S-I...
Insurance company? This is Mr. Lars Hansen of 118 Steiner Street. I have a small life insurance policy with you, and it is due. Yeah, well, will it be all right if I pay after next Friday? Will that be all right? Yeah. Oh, no, do not come to my house. I will come to you if you please. Yeah?
And I remember how finally the night of the spelling bee came.
Papa says not to play. You might disturb Dagmar.
Gosh, but she can't spell by this time. She doesn't have time to learn.
That's what you think. They're going over some extra special words right now.
But any minute we've got to leave for the spelling bee.
Well, I can't help it. They're cramming.
I never knew Papa to take such an interest in schoolwork.
You know how he is about Dagmar.
He's no different about Dagmar than he is about you and about me.
But Dagmar's littler and Papa likes that.
Hey, that's Papa's pipe.
Just between us. Papa is a big child himself.
Nels Hansen, you're being disrespectful.
I am not.
But you said Papa was a child.
He is. He loves games, parcheesi, piggyback, things like that.
He's a wonderful father.
Well, just the same, if I ever get married and have kids, you won't catch me wasting the time with them that Papa does with us.
If you ever have children, they'll probably be in the sideshow at Barnum and Bailey's Circus.
Well, is everybody ready for the things at the school?
Mama, Jenny's down here.
There's no need to call. Here I am.
Well, is Dagmar going to win the spelling bee?
Oh, I hope so, for Lars' sake. I have never seen anybody so excited.
Oh, but it's foolishness, all this education for girls. All they need is to read the recipes and write their name on the marriage license.
Nowadays, they are educating them more.
Well, out of books, girls just get crazy ideas, wrinkles, and spectacles. Never a husband. When are you going to get married?
Me, Aunt Jenny?
Well, she has time yet. She is 14 only.
Still, our mother was married by then.
Well, it is in the old country. Things are different here.
Well, that doesn't say that they are best.
Give me a word, somebody.
Old maid.
Old maid. O-L-D-M-A-I-D. Old
that maid. Means you're going to be one because you know how to spell it.
Well, you can tease, but just the same, I am right.
Dagmar, should I bring the speller with me?
Oh, no, Papa. I can't have it with me.
Well, hello, Hansen.
Oh, hello, Jenny.
Well, is Dagmar going to be queen of the bees?
She's a good speller, Jenny.
Yeah, so is the Tommy Jordan. Well, that's what Mrs. Yondrud says.
Oh, but what does it matter? That is only a game. Now it is time we must go.
Yeah. Come on, Papa. You can give me words
yeah,
on the way.
Pyramid. You missed that one.
Pyramid. P-Y-R-A-M-I-D.
Yeah.
You think she was graduating from high school?
You think Papa was graduating from high school? Now, where did I put my pocket?
Oh, here it is, Mama.
Come on, girls. We do not want to be late.
Yeah, we are coming.
And Martha, you know those friends of Mrs. Yondrud's friends?
Yeah.
The one that gambled? He is in Yale.
Portent.
Portent. P-O-R-T-E-N-T. Portent.
Sphinx.
Sphinx. S-P-H-I-N-X. Sphinx.
Casual.
Casual. C-A-S-U-A-L. Casual.
Anxious.
Anxious. A-N-X-I-O-U-S. Anxious.
Well, that is good, yeah.
Don't get excited, Papa. They give the easy words first.
Pneumonia.
Pneumonia. N-A-M-O-I-N-A. Pneumonia.
Sit down, please. Pneumonia.
Pneumonia. P-N-E-U-M-O-N-I-A. Pneumonia.
Paradox.
Paradox. P-A...
Beautiful.
Beautiful. B-E-A-U-T-I-F-U-L. Beautiful.
Mosaic.
Mosaic. M-O...
Is it C?
Yes, Papa. Mosaic. M-O...
Proceed, please.
Mosaic. M-O...
You have 3 seconds.
Mosaic, M-O-S-A-I-C! Mosaic.
Excuse me.
Daughter.
Daughter. D-A-U-G-H-T-E-R. Daughter.
View.
View. V-E-I-W.
View.
View. V-I-E-W. View. B-I-C-Y-C-L-E. Bicycle.
Esophagus.
Esophagus. E-S-O-P-H-A-G-U-S. Esophagus.
Zephyr.
Zephyr. Z-E-P-H... Y? R. Zephyr.
Difference.
Difference. D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-C-E. Difference.
Scissors.
Scissors. S-C-I-S-S-O-R-S. Scissors.
Mississippi.
Mississippi. Capital M-I-S. S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. Mississippi.
Feudal.
Feudal. F-U-E-D-A-L. Feudal.
Feudal.
Feudal. F-E-U-D-A-L. Feudal.
Is she still bawling?
She just feels awful, poor kid.
To trip up on an easy word like feudal.
Feudal isn't so easy.
Oh, it is after all the hard ones she spells.
just wish she wouldn't take it this way.
Papa's pretty upset, too.
Well, naturally, we all wanted her to win.
Well, at least Mr. Jordan is happy. Did you see him rubbing his hands?
You know something funny, Nels? Tommy seemed almost as upset as Dagmar.
No wonder. Spelling all those words, it's an ordeal.
No, Nels. I want you to go down to Keith's drugstore, and I want you to get us some ice cream. We are going to have a party for the best fella we ever had in the Hansen family.
Yeah. I don't want to have a party.
No, no. Do not cry, Olivia.
Go on, Nels. Get the ice cream. Neapolitan.
Oh, boy.
Now, calm down. Let me sit over here. Don't be feet so bad. No.
Now, sit down, Mama.
She don't feel bad, Dagmar. You're the best girl speller in the whole Lord grade.
But I didn't win.
You did, except for that one word.
But I didn't. And now something awful will happen to Papa.
Huh?
What will happen to Papa?
Won't he die now that he hasn't got any life insurance to protect him?
What is this about life insurance?
Well, Tommy told me that his father and Papa had made a bet. Papa bet the life insurance money that I'd win. And I didn't.
Don't you worry, Dagmar. Nothing is going to happen to Papa.
I only bet the money, Lilliman, because I wanted Mr. Jordan to know that I thought just as much of you as he did of Tommy.
But you lost the money. It's not my fault. Oh.
No, you did wonderful tonight, Lilliman. If anybody was to blame, it is your papa to bet. Of course, I do not know how.
I do not worry, Dagmar. We will find more money for the insurance somehow.
I'll get it. Feudal. F-E-U-D-A-L. Oh, darn it, why couldn't I have said that?
Oh,
Mr. Jordan.
Hello.
Oh, Tommy.
Hello, Mr. Jordan.
Hello,
Mr.
Hello,
folks.
Hello,
Tommy.
Hello, Tommy.
Well, tell them, Tommy.
I cheated, Dagmar.
What?
I cheated. Pa'd been after me about the bet and everything, and I was scared to lose.
You cheated? How?
Well, there was one word I could never spell. So I wrote it on my hand. Look. I would have missed it, and you would have been the champion, Dagmar.
That's what I get for driving the kid so hard, I guess. After it was over, I noticed he was acting kind of funny, and I says, what's the trouble? Then he showed me that hand. Well, I'll report this to the principal in the morning.
Oh, wait, Mr. Jordan. I think if anybody should be reported to the principal, it should be you two grown-up men betting on a child's game. Tommy, spell Mississippi with your hands closed.
Capital M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I.
Yeah, you see? You can spell it.
But I don't think I could act tonight. I was scared.
So was I.
So I guess you're the real champion, Dagmar.
Oh, I was so scared, Tommy. I don't think I could have spelled Mississippi either.
Sure you could have.
Well, all I know is that I wish I had field written on my hand.
By Dagmar Hansen.
Well, what about Papa's bet?
Oh, I think maybe Mrs. Jordan and I will divide that.
What?
Yeah, you bet your life.
Oh. And though Papa never made another bet, Mama joked he was a better man. I remember all the things, great and small, that happened on Steiner Street. I remember how overjoyed we were when school let out for the summer months. I remember the excitement Dagmar and I felt the morning Uncle Chris came bright and early with his automobile to take us to his farm for a vacation. For the farewell breakfast, Mama made some of her famous Norwegian waffles. Heart-shaped they were, I remember, and golden brown. I shall never forget how delicious they tasted that morning. What a wonderful feeling to be young and going away on a holiday.
And before setting out on the happy holiday journey, what's more fitting than a hearty send-off with a cup of warming Maxwell House? Good coffee goes with family moments like this, and good to the last drop Maxwell House gives friendly pleasure to more families the world over than any other brand. Now, there's a mighty solid reason behind this real preference for our famous blend. In a nutshell, it's our special recipe. Mama or any other good cook can tell you how important a recipe is, and that's what our Maxwell House people have, a recipe. A particular way of blending the various coffees together, the one and only recipe for good to the last drop flavor. There are scores of good coffees on the market today. But just as there's only one way, one recipe for Mama's wonderful waffles here, there's only one way, one recipe in the world for that wonderful flavor of Maxwell House. Ah, that's the secret, all right. Our special recipe. And it spells the difference between just an everyday coffee and coffee with flavor at its hearty holiday best. You can count on that flavor, cup after cup, because we're proud of it. Our Maxwell House, you can be sure, will never let you down. So, when you're buying coffee these days, and all summer long, remember the sign of good coffee. It's your surest guide to today's coffee buy. For, at today's prices, Maxwell House is more than ever today's coffee buy. Next time you shop, pick up a pound in the familiar blue tin. Pound after pound, always good to the last drop. Marks the start of a summer vacation for Mama and the Hansen family.
We
wish
you
a
happy
summer.
Summer. S-U-M-M-E-R. Summer.
Now, this is Alan Williams saying goodnight for Maxwell House Coffee and thanking you for inviting us into your homes each week. Our Maxwell House family hopes your family has a pleasant summer. And we look forward to seeing you again in August, 8 weeks from tonight. Good night.
Yes, always look for this Bird's Eye Bird, your guarantee of top quality frozen food. And your big Bird's Eye buy this week is Bird's Eye Orange Juice. Easy, you can serve it in a minute. Thrifty, it will save you money. Orchard fresh and delicious.
Better buy Bird's Eye. Better buy Bird's Eye.
The narrations on the preceding program are transcribed. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting.